characters, when you meet them and you get a chance to really be around them and get to know them, real cool.
Give it to Donald Trump, and he did it. You see that? He did it. He set it all up. He knew what was going to happen. So when it happens, you know that he knew it was going to happen.
You heard it here first, MTV News.
He's getting bored with rap, period, with hip-hop. Until, because it was the same shit, like the same crews, the same artists, the same everything. And then he was like, it wasn't until he listened to the joint that he said, yo, this is the next, this is the shit right here, the next thing, you know what I mean? And then he was like, y'all need the next thing to come out to be on the, you know, Shady. And I spoke to Dre, and we, you know, we said, tomorrow we're going to meet with Dre, and we'll sit down together. So me and M met first. Because M kind of like, he kind of wanted it, and then said, let me bring Dre in it, you know what I'm saying, to make it right.
What's up? I'm 50 Cent.
What's Eminem?
It's my man M here. Yo, good looking man. Good looking man for sounding me, see? Yo.
Then the following day, we met at an editing studio in Los Angeles, and they was editing the 8 Mile joint, and Drake pulled up and shit, and he got out and we kicked it, and he kind of, you know, he could see from my vibe the first time that we was around each other that it was like, you know, that he wanted to do it. You know, I was sure he wanted to do it, you know, from what he heard. And then when we left, I was like, all right, so it's a wrap, let's make it happen. When I turned the album, niggas turned around, bought me a watch. Got a watch. They had to pay like $750,000 for it. I don't know exactly how much they paid for it, but I know if I get rid of it, they're gonna give me $500,000 for it. Cause I'm with the check, nigga. Y'all got footage of that, y'all gonna play it back for me. Show me motherfucking watch and shit. I'm sure y'all need to get another good look at this motherfucker right here, huh? There's a Vincent Constance, you can't pronounce what this shit is, nigga. Don't be mad, nigga, cause you signed the wrong motherfucking deal. Don't get mad, nigga. You all fucked up. You roll with them niggas ain't even feeding you. You all fucked up, man. Like, the game is small. There's not a lot of places that you could go and win. Like, you know, like, I had met with Capitol Records. That's cash out. If I took Capitol Records money, I'm just buying guns with it. I'm finna shoot some shit up. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'd be taking that money to go to the hood hard. Dre from NWA. How can he not understand what 50 Cent is doing right now? You know, like, and him, if, like, the way he has the same approach towards another class of people. You feel me? The Christina Aguilera's, the Moby, the, you know, he has the same. Like, if you say something to him, he's gonna get you. Literally, he's gonna get you to the point that you like, because you hear it on the radio all day, every day. So you can't escape him. Producing a record, my records, I do the vocals, and then when Dre hear the vocals, we do the vocals. You understand what I'm saying? He produces the fucking record. Like, the record, at the end of the day, what the record sounds like is my words, my cadences, and then Dre's vision to the way it should sound and how the beat should drop or should move or where we should expand the shit at and where we should leave it. That's all him. If Dre said, yo, I don't think you should do that right now, I scrap the shit based on his. He'll explain why he thinks I shouldn't do it. And then I go, okay, scrap it. Let's go to something else. You understand what I'm saying? And I take their opinions past just the word respect. Like, respect someone's opinion, it's past that. Like, if they say it, it's gone. Let's go to the next thing. Why? Because I don't get personal with the music. You're not, you hear a joint, you're like, this is my shit right here. Like, I need this record. I don't really feel like that about any of the records. I don't think it's entertaining to just be one way. So I don't think I have a style, a specific way that you can, like, label me. Because I'll try any fucking thing. I'll get in there, if it feel right to me, I'm going to do that shit. You know what I'm saying? And then I'm going to listen to it, I'm going to play it back, and then I'm going to send it to Dre. And if Dre like it, then we're going to use that motherfucker. Between Dre and him, is after what I do, It is what it is, you know what I'm saying? But I don't have a boundary. Like, I fucking do whatever. You know? Except sing on a fucking pop record. Like, I ain't with all that dumb shit. G-Unit, I decided to, I wanted to put together, you know what I'm saying? Think all the way through. You know what I'm saying? And I was thinking all the way through. I'm planning all the way through. And I know I don't want to be a rapper forever. You know what I mean? I want to be like, you see how Dre, you know, his company is going, and M is a part of his company, and I'm a part of his company, and those things are happening, and he still has the ear where he can sign the biggest projects in the business. You know what I mean? And I want to be able to do those things too, so I want to set up where I can do that, and that's what the process was with me getting Tony Yayo and Lloyd Banks. Tony Yayo is like, he sell drugs, like he's a little hustler nigga, you know what I mean? So he run around, hustling, do his thing. He was rolling with me from my first record, the whole time he was around. So he just wasn't getting ready to showcase him, you know what I mean? Like he wasn't really ready to be a solo artist at that point. Banks rapped on one mixtape before I got him. Like, I got him fresh off the stoop.
I battled every nigga there was. You know what I mean? Like, your name, your street credibility, it shit starts piling up, and there's only so many times you're gonna hear that same nigga name before you decide to go, yo, you know what? I'm gonna take you with me.
He's super talented. You know what I mean? He couldn't get a record deal without me because his character won't allow him to speak to a nigga. Like, he doesn't do anything. Like, he'll fall back and won't say that to you. You think he don't like you. Not that he doesn't like you, it's just that's who he is. Like, that's his character.
My style is like, who the fuck are you? Like, that's who my style is. My shit is so, like, raw and raunchy, like, nigga, get away from me. Like,
G-Unit, man. The whole movement, man. You're destroying shit, man. I love this rap shit, man. This rap game, man. Ain't nothing better than this, man. That's what I live for, man. For real. Sean Money himself.
Sean Money is like the fucking chain on the bike, man. He makes everything, you know, he talks to the people I don't want to talk to. Like, you know, like, he handles a lot of bullshit and gets frustrated a lot, and I be smiling because he's frustrated when I should be frustrated. Y'all could produce a lot of records. Like, he could produce a hot producer, but on this record, he knew, like, that.
Pacifico is brewed for those who like
that. I wanted it to be various, so he spent a lot of time, he played an executive more on this album than he did the actual producer. Group shit is easy for them, like, it's so easy for us to make records. It's like, Lloyd Banks, their progress is so fast, it's scary. Like, it's like, oh shit, like, the momentum, the energy that they hear when people say, yo, G-Unit, that's the shit, or that's hot. It's giving them so much confidence that they're fucking writing better.
The buzz in the street, over to the mixtapes, really heated up and it took over the fucking mixtapes, man. I'm just fortunate to get into it at the time where they start understanding.
Now they real popular in New York City to the point that people calling me, and I showed you a page yesterday on the shoot.
Read this message, see what it say? Steve is going to the extreme. He just called myself. Tommy on the line saying they want to turn G-Unit into the next Rough Riders. I told them to call Tio.
That's Steve Stout. That's Tommy Mottola. I'm not interested, okay? I'm over here with Dr. Dre. Eminem, you heard me? I'm fucking in this car. I don't give a fuck.
Turn down two deals. That's two deals we turned down.
I'm dirty. I'm dirty. I'm dirty with money, nigga.
Second one got to be for three and better.
G-Unit is like the firm, kid. You get in, you can't get out. It's like, it's already like, they ain't going nowhere. They won't follow my lead. They offered $1 million for them separately. For Lloyd Banks and then for Tony Yayo separate. They ain't going nowhere. They're gonna wait till we do it the way I wanna do it. Cause that's gonna be the best way. In the end, they follow my lead. So it's like they would be uncomfortable doing the deal and being on their own to win. after they did it. You understand what I'm saying? Because then it's like, you do a deal over there, now we got to deal with that company and how they work. Nah, where you need to be? You need to be right in the middle of what I'm doing, so my influence is there to support the situation. That's what, I'm on the fucking dream team right now. I got the two biggest bodyguards I could possibly have at Interscope Records. Eminem and Dr. Dre, you heard me? You know, so fuck it up. If they fuck it up, they're fucking up Eminem and Dr. Dre's reputation. In a big way, because it's already established on the East Side, period. 50 Cent. These niggas talking tough, they lying. These niggas is pussy, yo. I'm telling you, these niggas is probably run this shit, nigga. I take care of all of the business for them. You understand what I'm saying? And it's like, they leave that, like, that's for you to go. You got that. Go do that. Let us do what, you know, what we've been doing so everything stays the way it is. That, now it ain't broke, let's not fix it. You know what I mean? And it works, but I want them to be able to function without me. You know what I mean? In the event that I'm not around or present, or if I'm doing something else at the time, like say I'm doing some film stuff or some other stuff, I want them to be able to move without me being there, to, you know? After my first week of sales, I'm going in to start negotiating for my own label deal. I'm waiting for that because I feel like I'm gonna do more than they're anticipating me to do. And when that happens, they'll go, oh, okay, we need to, you know, follow what he says, because he knows what he's saying. I don't think that they really realize the momentum. I think I'm going to sell 5 million records. If it's not this record, it's, I'm going to have an album to sell 5 million records. And I mean, M to 16. God damn, nigga. Dre put up 8. They put up numbers, big numbers. You know? But 5 is a nice number. Nice round number. I know when I speak, I represent niggas on every corner. From Brooklyn, Bronx, Manhattan, New York City, state of mind, that everything. That shit is a